Now, we say that the gift of knowledge and discerning of spirits sometimes work very closely together as allied gifts of the Spirit. I remember a very clear instance of that. We had a lady in our fellowship who came in with a back problem. She had been driving a school bus, and she went to shift the gears on the school bus, and something happened to her back. She had gone to a doctor, had her back x-rayed, and the doctor said, "You have a double curvature of your spine. You were born that way. You've been that way since birth, and because your spine is not straight but is curved, it has caused a weakness, and that's when you put the pressure trying to shift the gears, the reason something went out in your back." Well, she had been suffering that way for about a week down in bed. She managed to crawl out of bed and make it down to the church office. There were two of us pastors there to minister to her that day. And as we began to pray for her, God showed me a vision. Now, sometimes the word of knowledge or even discerning of spirits will come in the form of a vision. And in this word of knowledge, I saw a birthday cake. It was a white birthday cake. It had red lettering on the top of it. It had a number 32 on the top of the birthday cake in red letters. And I said to her, I said, "Does a birthday cake with 32 on it mean anything to you?" She said, "Well, only this, that within 3 months, I will be 32 years of age." The other brother who was ministering said, "Well, as we were praying and seeking the Lord, God gave me discernment on a spirit of rejection." So we put the two together, the word of knowledge, the discerning of the spirit, and saw that this woman had a spirit of rejection that entered her while she was still in her mother's womb 3 months before she was born. So we proceeded, and we cast out the spirit of rejection out of her spine, and immediately her spine straightened up. Her husband looked at her that night, and he knew something had happened to her, and he said, "You're taller than you used to be." And so he measured her and found out that she had increased 2 inches in stature as a result of the straightening of her spine. But she was instantly healed. The sequel to that was that she didn't know that she was rejected by her mother before she was born, but her mother still living. She asked her mother if that was true, and her mother admitted it. She says, "Yes." She said, "I did not want you. In fact, I got up on the dresser, and I jumped off several times trying to abort you before you were born." So there it was. See, that's the way, an illustration of how these gifts of the Spirit operate. Now, the discerning of spirits is supernatural insight into the spirit realm. See, it doesn't say the gift of discernment, but it says the gift of the discerning of spirits. It's not a general discernment of discerning all things, but it is a limited discerning, a discerning of spirits. Now, it's very valuable to discern spirits. And let me give you some of the purposes, how valuable this gift is. This gift will disclose the presence and the operation of evil spirits. You know, I can look back and I can see that God provided the resources that I needed for the ministry of deliverance. He knew from the day that He baptized me in the Holy Spirit the emphasis that He was going to give me in deliverance. Now, I didn't know it, but God did. And as I said to begin with, God began to equip me. And so the next day, after I received the baptism of the Holy Spirit, which was in a full gospel businessmen's convention in Denver, Colorado, I was in the meeting, and they had asked me to go to the platform and give my testimony. After I finished my testimony, they asked me to sit on the platform for a little while. And I looked, and there were a bunch of hippies in the back whom the businessmen had encouraged and invited to come to the meeting in hoping that many of them would become saved. And I looked, and three of them got up and started to the platform. And suddenly I knew something was wrong. I looked at those, and I didn't know anybody in that meeting personally, and a man sitting next to me, I said, "Look, that fellow has a demon in him." And the man looked at me and he said, "You must have a discerning of spirits." Now see, I had not studied the discerning of spirits. I didn't know what a discerning of spirits was. And so I said to the man, "Well, I don't know what I've got, but I know what he's got." So God was equipping us. And in that same meeting, God gave Adam A the word of faith for deliverance. She was one in the audience that stood up. And when those three men were on the platform trying to intervene and interrupt the meeting, she and several others stood up and rebuked spirit. She'd only had the baptism 2 weeks. She'd never been in a meeting like this. She'd never seen anything like this. Had no idea in the natural what was going on. And here she stands up and starts rebuking demons. And all three of those fellas, bang, 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 hit the floor. Hallelujah. Discerning of spirits. It's good to know what's going on in the spirit realm.